I'm Shirin Merchant, and today we're going to talk about playing tug with your dog. Tug is just such a misunderstood topic. A lot of people think it brings out aggression in dogs. Some people don't want to play it. So I thought I'd bust a few myths here in the video today. So I've got in my hand a couple of tug toys that we can use to play tug. So make sure if you are playing tug with your dog, it's with the correct toys. Also understand, when you play tug with a dog, you first teach the dog control, which means how to leave the toy. Don't play tug without teaching that command. Always have the control in first, and then we get the dog excited. If you teach the dog to get excited before you put in control, you just lose control of the game and it'll just become a mess. So I've got a couple of toys here. This is one that you could use for a tug. This is another tug toy. Remember, with any tug toy, it's got to be long enough for you to be able to safely hold one end as the dog holds the other end. Small toys, even something like this, though it is a good tug toy, this puts your hand really close to the dog's mouth, which you don't want when you play tug, because sometimes as the dog leaves and grabs to hold the toy again, it can grab your hand by mistake. So these toys, which are long enough, are great for playing tug. Remember, you can't play tug with a tennis ball. It's got to be a specific tug toy. So I'm going to call over my little doggy now, Chica. Chica's a Belgian Malinois. And I'm going to show you how I play tug with her. But I need to put away some of these so that she doesn't get excited. Chica, Chica, come. Where have I got? So I've got Chica now. And we're going to play a game of tug. Remember, it's a Malinois, so they get very worked up with this game. So remember, we have taught her, Chica, the leave command, and she needs it. Chica, out. Good girl. What a good girl. So we've got another doggy here, Maya, a little Labrador. And as you can see, Maya enjoys playing tug as well. Remember, as I said earlier, you should have a toy where you can hold safely without your hand being very close to the dog's mouth. When you play tug, try to avoid playing side to side. Okay? So when you play, don't let the dog shake it side to side. That brings about a latent aggression. You can see. So if you're playing tug, a good way to do it, so don't let the dog do that. Try to do it up to down. Control the tug game. So you know, with tug, it's a great game. With a lot of dogs that lack confidence, that are shy, when you play tug with them and you let them win the toy, which is what I'm going to let her do now, I'm going to let her win it, it builds confidence in the dog. With a lot of dogs that are overconfident, you want to win the game more. And you can actually turn the dog's emotional state, build and lower. Maya, come. Build and lower confidence when you play. Maya, come. Maya, come. Good girl. Good girl. So remember, tug can be a great game. Just make sure you have the control. Maya, leave. 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 Good girl. Ah, sit. Sit. Good girl. So stay with this level of control. It can be difficult because dogs really get excited. Just hang in there. You don't need choke chains, prong collars. And play tug games. Play them carefully. Play them well. And it can't go wrong. Thank you, and see you soon in another video.